how will the world, including Canada, meet its energy needs? We need cleaner and smarter energy solutions. We need new and more sustainable energy sources paired with smart grids and energy storage technologies. Are you the scientists and engineers we're looking for? Do you have the next big idea that'll transform our world and lead us down the path of change? Are you inspired enough to invent the innovative energy technologies we need to improve our quality of life and heal our planet? Before you get all excited and jump on our bandwagon, we need to go back for a history lesson. Not far enough. Want some sausages? We'll get to that later. No, we need to go way, way back. Too far. Well, not really, but for our purposes, we'll skip forward a bit. Ultimately, almost all of our energy comes from the sun. We can't create or destroy energy. We can only transform it. Fossil fuels used to be plants and animals, and we know from the food chain that it all started with the sun. The energy from the sun enabled the plants to make their own food from carbon dioxide and water. Then, animals ate the plants and other animals to meet their own energy needs, and so on, and so on. When the plants and animals died, they were under immense pressure for hundreds of millions of years, transforming into oil, natural gas, and coal. How are other sources of energy generated by the sun? The uneven heating of the Earth's atmosphere, caused by the sun, creates winds. Hydroelectric energy is the result of heat energy from the sun moving water through the water cycle and the gravitational forces from the Earth moving the water. A solar cell converts the energy of sunlight directly into electricity. Aside from tidal, geothermal, and nuclear energy, all of our energy sources were created by the sun's energy and transformed into another form of energy. Energy transformation is what fueled the Industrial Revolution. The potential chemical energy from photosynthesis, stored in coal, is transformed into thermal energy by burning. The heat is used to change liquid water into steam. Thermal energy is transformed into mechanical energy because steam expands to force a piston to move. Mechanical energy is transformed into kinetic energy because the pistons drive a shaft that eventually makes the wheels of the train turn. In 1831, Michael Faraday realized the link between a changing magnetic field and electrical energy. And that's when things really took off. When electrons are forced to move in sync, they can produce heat, and they can turn the wire they're moving in into a magnet. Heat can boil water and make light bulbs glow. Magnets can make things move. That is the magic behind every electrical appliance. That is the science behind every electrical appliance. We turn a turbine to make a big magnet move around a wire to generate electricity. Hydro or wind energy use water or air to actually spin the turbine. Combustion, the burning of fossil fuels, or nuclear energy, heat water to steam. The expanding gases turn the turbine. And therein lies the rub. We've been burning coal to run engines since the 1700s. All that carbon the plants and animals pulled from the atmosphere 300 million years ago is being released back into the atmosphere in a much shorter time frame. But we are intelligent and inventive beings. We can solve this problem. Half of our energy consumption can be eliminated by increasing the efficiencies of our buildings, vehicles, and appliances, and the other half by using carbon-free sources of energy. We need our best and brightest of the next bright generation to create innovative solutions for energy storage, because wind and solar energy don't produce electricity according to our schedules. We need solutions to improve the efficiency of energy generation and transmission. And we need to come up with sustainable, non-carbon-based forms of energy to generate the electricity and clean water we need to maintain and improve all of our lives. We need a better battery or a better system of batteries to store energy, especially electricity. The lithium-ion battery changed electronics and how we communicate with each other. New battery technology is going to transform just about everything else. How we keep the lights on, how we travel, and how to spread power to those without it. Meeting our energy needs and protecting our planet can be a daunting task. There are people currently working on innovative technologies to enable us to reduce energy consumption while maintaining our lifestyles. What new transportation technologies can you design? Will you help figure out fusion on a smaller scale? People are designing homes that are completely off the grid. Can you come up with technology to help everyone contribute? In the future, a smart, widespread electrical grid will be connected to more efficient transmission lines. We can create a system that moves electricity from where it's produced to where it's needed, when it's needed, and at the right power levels. Look at what we've done here at Science North. Science North has installed a smart microgrid to help us reduce the net amount of energy we consume from the local grid. With on-site photovoltaic or solar panels and a battery for energy storage, we'll have more control over our energy usage. Electricity generated by the solar panels can be directed to three different areas. They include the local electrical grid, the battery, and the science center. Among many other advantages, control over our electricity generation will enable Science North to protect the F. Jean McLeod Butterfly Gallery microclimate in power outage situations. Science North's microgrid is a small-scale version of the centralized electricity system. It will generate, distribute, and regulate the flow of electricity, ensuring a sustainable energy future. The new revolution would mean energy used more wisely, more widely, and more cleanly. We need the next generation of innovative thinkers to come up with the unthinkable. We need you to be intellectually fearless and solve our impossible problems. Are you up to the task? Are you ready to be a part of the new revolution?